Here we are at the St. Elizabeth Spiritual Baptist Church. It's a very beautiful morning, as you can see around. This is the St. Elizabeth Spiritual Baptist Church. St. Louis and the Grenadines.
He knows what I need. He knows what I need. So stay online.
Save me by his wonderful grace, by his wonderful grace.
Jesus took me in, and then a light from heaven filled my soul. It bathed my heart in love and wrote my name above. And just a little talk with Jesus made me whole. Now let us stand and talk with Jesus. Let us stand on our tongues. He will hear our praise, and he will answer by and by. And you will find a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
Wonderful Peter, oh wonderful.
done, we'll soon be done with troubles and trials. Troubles and trials, safe from heartache, pain and care. We shall all that glory share, and none go sit down beside my Jesus. Lord, go sit down and rest for a little while. We'll soon be done, we'll soon be done with troubles and trials. Troubles and trials, in that hall. Kindred and friends now wait for me. Soon their faces I shall see. We'll soon be done. We'll soon be done with troubles and trials. Troubles and trials. 'Tis a home of life so fair,
and we'll all be gathered there.
And I'm gonna sit down beside my Jesus. Lord, I'm gonna sit down and rest a little while. We'll soon be done. We'll soon be done with troubles and trials. Troubles and trials in that home. We'll soon be done,
we'll soon be done with troubles and trials.
Troubles and trials, oh, what peace and joy supply. In that home of love divine, and I'm gonna sit down beside my Jesus. Lord, I'm gonna sit down and rest a little while. We'll soon be done,
we'll soon be done with troubles and trials.
Troubles and trials in that home. Thank you.
pass along, cheering those who can make me alone. My skill, heal, heal, heal the world of a smiling day. Helping someone on life's way. From the paths of sin, bring the warring birds into the master's fold to stay. Help to cheer up all those that have sat. Help to make some fear in their prayer. Let your mind so be that all the world may see the joy of serving Jesus Christ. Someone knows and lies away. From the paths of sin, bring the warring birds into the master's fold to stay. Help to cheer the cold and sad. Help to make some fear in their head. Let your life so be that all the world may see the joy of serving Jesus with a smile.
Yeah. Tell me some man with a man. Is it walking? Huh? Good morning, church. As the pastor had said, that it's open tribute now. So I want to pay a tribute kindly. I'm inviting those outside to come in kindly. Please be seated as I give this tribute. Thank you. Turn the music down. Okay then. Again, I'm going to say good morning. I'm here to pay tribute to the late Mr. John, better known as Theophilus Ezekiel Young, but in the community where I happen to be an adopted member of this community, we know him as Boy John. Today we know that death is inevitable, and one of these days, you and I will go through the same phase. But I want to encourage us here today, as an audience, as a congregation who has come to pay the last respect, Mr. John lived a full life. I remember him in the community as a jovial man. He was very quiet. He lived a life, well, he was very jovial, as I said before, very quiet. Myself and him periodically will have some fun. And I want to thank you this morning that none of us knows our life destiny. I remembered quite vividly a few months ago I saw him, and the last chat I had, I went to the shop to buy a pack of peanuts, and he was saying something to me and I smiled. And from that day I didn't see him. He was hospitalized. He came home and he was there. He had a short illness, and eventually he expired. Today, none of us knows our life destiny. And as a community, as a nation, let us, by God's grace, live in unity. Today, our dear brother has gone. A member from the community has gone. But I want us today, as encourage myself, to be a brother's keeper. No man is an island. God make us to be united, and at the end of life journey, it is not so much what we accumulate in life. What is important is a relationship with God. Brother John has gone. His days on earth has ended. Right as he take his last salute today, it is only good night. We shall see him in the morning. To the Dix family, to the Wilson's family, we are extending our deep heart sympathy. So on behalf of the community of Glenmorgan, I want to express my deepest condolences to the family. And I'm going to leave this word with you. I'm pressing on the upward way. New heights I'm gaining every day. Lord, plant my feet in higher ground. So to the family, to the community, it is only good night. I'll see him in the morning. Let us hold on tenaciously to the Lord. Death is only a separation. When Jesus Christ comes, it's a relationship. To the audience, to this congregation, to the pastor of this church, let us remember that Jesus Christ is coming soon. And to the family, be steadfast, because when death comes, There is no repentance in the grave. And to those of us who have not accepted Christ as their Savior and their friend, do it now, because life is fleeting. Be strong. I love you. I thank you. In God's grace, amen.
Final view, because we are going at 11, we are going to close. And remember, when we close, we are not opening again. So those of you who want to have the final look, you can do it now, so that we can proceed in the service.
Morning to everyone. God is good and all the time. God is good. Now I'm here to pay tribute on behalf of the Glamorgan Sports Club, members, the community. Just want to say that, you know, it's a little difficult time now, but whatever the circumstances, God knows best, and we want to say God is good.
Amen.
Thank you. My tribute will be in song, and I think it's something that everyone knows. So you're welcome, everyone, if you know that can sing along. It's no problem. Just sing along. It's a song that I believe everybody knows. Sorry about the music now. Forever with the Lord. Amen. My Father's house on high, home of my soul, how near. At times to fate foreseeing I, thy golden gates appear. And then my spirit faints to reach the land I love, the bright inheritance of Jerusalem above. Forever with the Lord, Father, it is thy will, the promise of that faithful word is yet to me fulfilled. Be thou at my right hand, the glad I never fail. Fight and I must prevail. So when my latest breath shall rend the veil in twain, by death
Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me will live, even though they die. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Eternal God is your refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. The hour is coming, and now it is, when the dead hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. At every turn, life links us to the Lord. And when we die, we've come face to face with him. In life or death, we are in the hands of the Lord. Christ lived and died and lives again to establish his lordship over the dead. Things beyond our sin, things beyond our hearing, things beyond our imagination have all been prepared by God the Father for those who love him through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I just want to welcome each and everyone to St. Elizabeth Spiritual Baptist Cathedral here at Belmont. And if it is the first time that you are attending, we welcome you. I pray this morning that each heart will be blessed. We have seen that one that was with us is no more. And soon and very soon, we too will pass this life. So I pray, Lord, that our hearts will be ready to be with the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
Let us pray. Eternal Father, who by thy mighty power didst raise up our Lord Jesus Christ from the dead, strengthen us now by thy Holy Spirit, the Comforter. Help us to worship thee with reverence and submissive hearts, and to put our whole trust in thy perfect wisdom, power, and love. Bless to us the reading of the words of eternal life, that by steadfastness and by encouragement of the scripture, we may have hope and be lifted up out of darkness and distress into the marvelous light and power of thy presence through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Dear Heavenly Father, this morning we come in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord God, we just want to thank you for waking us up in our right mind and for bringing us here safely this morning. Father God, you know the occasion why we have gathered here on the behalf of one who has passed this life. And so God, we just want to pray, oh God, for those bereaved families who have lost their loved ones, that they may realize and know, oh God, that one day they too will be just like him. And so I pray if their hearts are not right with you, if they have not turned over their life to you, they will do so before time tracy. And for all of us over here this morning, especially for the sinner man, that they will realize and look closely to know that one who was here with them is not here anymore. And they must consider and know that they too will be just like him. And so Father, before it is too late, that they will turn over their whole life to you, O God, before it is too late this morning. And for those of us who have already given your hearts and living for you, O God, we'll take one step closer to you. And so, Father, as we are about to go through this proceeding, we ask your blessing upon the word, which will come forth a little later. So help us, O God, that we may swing our hearts so wide open and bid you enter in. Bless us all this morning. In Jesus' name I pray with thanksgiving.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Can we say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
Can we praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
We are not dead.
Hallelujah.
We are not dead. The one who is dead cannot hear us. Amen? Amen. The one who is dead cannot hear us, but we are here to praise the Lord. We are not here to praise the dead. But we are here to praise the Maker and Redeemer of us all. Like a river. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Spirit of God. Praise the name of Jesus. Oh, and peace like a river attendeth
my way.
When sorrows I see,
it is
my soul, with my soul. with my soul. I do hope and trust all of us here this morning. Can you really truly say it is well with your soul? I can say it is well with my soul. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And as the songwriter declared, though Satan should buffet, though trials will come, let this blessed assurance control. Hallelujah. This morning we know that Christ had come and take away sin by giving his life so that we truly can say, it is well with my soul. And if it is not well with your soul, now is the time to make right. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We have the first reading taken from Psalm 90. And next to the one Psalm we do that reading. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord.
Good morning, church. The scripture reading will be taken from Psalms 90. We read it in its entirety from the King James Version. Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or even thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Thou turnest man to destruction, and sayest, return, ye children of men, for 1,000 years in thy sight are but as yesterday when it is past, and as a watch in the night. Thou carriest them away as with a flood. They are as asleep. In the morning they are like grass which groweth up. In the morning it flourisheth and groweth up. In the evening it is cut down and weareth and withereth. For we are consumed by thine anger, and by thy wrath are we troubled. Thou hast set our iniquities before thee, our secret sins in the light of thy countenance. For all our days are passed away in thy wrath. We spent our years as a tale told. The days of our years are 70, and if by reason of strength, they be 80 years. Yet is their strength labor and sorrow, for it is soon cut off, and we fly away. We know it the power of thine anger, even according to thy fear, so is thy wrath. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Return, O Lord, how long? And let it repent thee concerning thy servants. O satisfy us early with thy mercy, that we are rejoiced and be glad all our days. Make us glad according to the days wherein thou hast afflicted us, and the years wherein we have seen evil. Let thy work appear unto thy servants, and thy glory unto their children. And let the beauty of the Lord our God be upon us, and establish thou the work of our hands upon us. Yea, the work of our hands establish thou it. Here ends the scripture reading.
Thanks, sir. The word of God and the Son and the Holy Spirit, that the blood shall be given some of the child, world without end. Amen. So here the psalmist is saying, asking the Lord to teach him to number the days. So we have seen that the brother day is already numbered. Amen. And so, our days too will be numbered when the time comes. Praise the Lord. We have another hymn, when the trumpet of the Lord shall sound. Oh, when the trumpet of the Lord shall sound,
oh,
of us will be there.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
But God has everyone time in his hand. Now we have our second scripture reading. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, from verse 13 to 18, by Jeremy, Corey, and Zachary B. and his sons. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Morning, everybody.
Morning.
This scripture reading is taken from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 13 to 18. But I would not you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord.
Wherefore comfort one another with these words. Here ended the scripture reading.
So for those of you who had a sign this morning, you hear what the brother said. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. So I pray this morning that your hearts are be comforted. Amen?
Amen?
Praise the Lord. Now we have a special tribute or hymn or hymn on the wings of a dove. And I think that was the son said to me this morning, this was one of the special, and we will play so that we can see. So you can just come up and
thank you.
Praise the Lord. We read scripture just read a while ago. We will get wings, amen? Because it said we will be caught up. We don't have wings to fly, we will be caught up to be with the Lord in the earth. And so shall we ever be with Him. I do hope and trust us. The song said a while ago to me that was the wrong song that we have here on the song sheet. So instead of the wings of a snow white dove, his wings like a dove. Praise the Lord this morning. I do hope and trust that he has wings so that he will be able to fly. But if he didn't have wings to fly to be with the Lord, sad will be his portion. Amen? And that goes for all of us. Because the dead cannot, praise the Lord. We cannot make it right. He cannot make it right now if he did not make it right. So it is for all of us who are here and do not give our life to the Lord Jesus Christ as yet to do so now. Now is the acceptable time. Now is the day of salvation. Death do not tell none of us when he's coming. So we all have to be ready. Hallelujah. And he said we all have to be ready. So that when death approaches our body, we will have wings so that we can fly to be with the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Now we have some special tribute. And the first one here is written by Erica Dick, the daughter, and recited by Anita Joseph. Granddaughter. Great granddaughter.
Good morning, everybody. So the first poem is entitled Letter to My Daddy by Evina Dick. A limb has fallen once again from our family tree. We all have lost a lovely soul, Pops, our loving daddy. The Lord saw him getting tired, so he called him home to rest. And while I'm fed with teary eyes, I am reminded God always takes the best. Day by day, we saw your pain as you gently fade away. Although we loved you dearly, Dad, we could not make you stay. Your golden heart stopped beating that night while you were sleeping. There, Dad, although you are gone, your memories still live on. And so I say goodbye for now as you take your final bow. Goodbye, Daddy. The second poem is entitled The Family Chain, and this is from me. We little knew that morning God was going to call your name. In life we loved you dearly, in death we did the same. It broke our hearts to lose you, you did not go alone, for a part of us went with you the day God called you home. You left us beautiful memories, your love is still our guide, and though we cannot see you, you are always by our side. Our family chain is broken and nothing seems the same. But as God calls us one by one, the chain will link again. Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Now we have a song by Kathleen Dick.
Good morning, all. Usually when somebody pass, you know, your family member usually asks, okay, what are we going to do? Who's doing this? Who's doing that? My husband asked me if I'm going to sing a song. And I said, yes. But then I'm trying to find a song, but I couldn't find any song. I said, I don't think I can sing again, man, because we can't find a song to sing. But last week, Saturday, while I was in the shower, some words came to me. And I said, okay, maybe I should write a song. And then I started writing. Sunday morning, while I was in church, the rest of the words came. And while I was there listening to the sermon, I finished my song. And my song is entitled, Don't Cry For Me. My time has come to leave this world. I know it's hard for you to let me go, but it's God's will, nothing we can do. Remember me, the time that we shared. Don't cry for me, don't shed a tear. I may be gone, but my memory still lives on. Don't cry for me, don't shed a tear. Don't you be dismayed, we'll meet again on Judgment Day. Don't cry for me, for everyone this road will take. It's not the end, judgment we still await. To live is Christ, to die is gain. Surrender now, you're all to Him. Remember this, your life belongs to Him. Let your light shine wherever you may go. Don't cry for me, don't shed a tear. I may be gone, but my memory still lives on. Don't cry for me, don't shed a tear. Don't be dismayed, we'll meet again. Don't cry for me, don't shed a tear. I may be gone, but my memory still lives on. Don't cry for me, don't shed a tear. I may be gone, but my memory still lives on. Don't cry for me, don't shed a tear. I may be gone, but my memory still lives on. Don't be dismayed, we'll meet again on Judgment Day. Don't cry for me, oh, don't cry for me.
By Gribbidine Wilson. I do believe that it's Pastor Gribbidine Wilson from the church of Thomas Miller.
Yes.
Hopefully.
That's correct. That's right. Correct.
Yes. And he is the nephew of the deceased.
Good morning, everyone. Pastor Davis and the family of the deceased. I'm here today filled with a lot of memories. My relationship with my uncle goes back to when I was a child, many, many years ago. He was my mother's brother. And my mother would always boast that he is the only brother she has with her mother. Of course, she has many more brothers because my grandfather was a police officer and he has many children. As a matter of fact, just 3 months ago, I attended the funeral of one of my uncles on the leeward side of the island. Uncle by mother, by grandfather. But, you know, when we were growing up as youngsters, I always reflect on the fact that my mother always sent us by Uncle Boy and Nicey. And we were coming empty-handed, but we were going back with maybe bananas, breadfruit, dashin, tanyas, edos, ground provision. And I was saying to to Gershom, not Gershom, sister here, that I will never forget those days, because we didn't have the lands. They had the lands, and they provided for us. And I always thank God for that. Uncle Boy and my family were very close. A matter of fact, when my father was building his home, Uncle Boy was there almost every time they were working on that house. And when he was building his home or his house, Daddy was there too. So they had a very, very close relationship. I suspect there might have been other things that brought them together, but they were close. And today, we are saddened in one sense that we are losing a very important and tremendous person in this life. I lost my mother in 1996. That's a good 8 years ago? And today, he lived up to this point in time. And for those of us who have the privilege to have known him, that's really an honor. And today we give our last tribute, as it were, our last goodbye to our uncle and to those, the children and grandchildren. You know, I would like to say that even though uncle has gone and mommy has gone, let us try to maintain some semblance of relationship over the years ahead. I have not been living in St. Vincent for a number of years, but the one person that I get to meet or see or hear from once I'm here is Gershom. And a couple of mornings ago, he called me and he said, "Cuz, I'm calling you with some sad news. Your uncle has passed." And yes, I actually became speechless. But we thank God that he was able to live a full life, you know? He was able to live a full life. And we give God thanks for his life, the example he has left, children he has nurtured, and the good things that he has passed on to them and to me as well. I say, may God bless his soul. May he rest in peace. God bless.
Praise the Lord. Yes. I can remember, as the brother said, some years ago, one day I was sitting in the porch and I saw coming up the road, passing my way. And he said, "Good morning." So I said, "Where are you coming from?" He said, "I was coming from my sister, because my side, the river divides Winston and we, you know, in Woodley on the other side." So he said he was coming from his sister, so he decided to walk this road and walk the favored side. He did not go back over to the fair hall, the other fair hall side. So I said, that lady is your sister? So he said, yes. So I can remember vividly that. Amen? And we pray God this morning that the pastor here has given some words concerning his uncle. Amen? So you know, when we lost a loved one, how hard it is. Have somebody who still loves even more, and that's the Lord Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. Now we have the reading by the Son portion. Hallelujah.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Losing a loved one is never easy. But before I do anything else here today, I just want to say thank you to everyone who showed up here today, who have given their condolences, sympathized with the family, expressed sorrow with us in any way, shape, or form. We, as a family, greatly appreciate that, and without that love and support, we couldn't make it through today. So thank you very much. My dad, thank you. And I know he would be proud to see you here today, so thank you. Theophilus Ezekiel Young, affectionately known as Ezekiel John, Boy John, or as we his children love to call him, Pops, was born on October 24, 1937. To Ancilla Young and Conrad John. He was the only boy among his mother's six children. After 85 fulfilling years, he was called home to be with the Lord on December 3rd, 2022. And I said 85 fulfilling years because for my entire life on earth, September of this year was the first time that I know my dad ever had to go to the hospital in that 85 years. So he indeed did live a fulfilling life. To help you understand Pop's background, and I think from here on I'll refer to him as Pops. Conrad, his dad, and for those older ones, and Moshe from out the road, were brothers. So my dad actually had to call Moshe uncle. Yep. So there's a little bit of context there. His mom was a McCall from right up at Belmont here as well. Yep. So McCall right at Cemetery Gate, my dad also had to call him uncle. Yep. Dad completed his early schooling at a private school owned by Vi Wiley, and later at Baskin School, a private school owned and operated by a Barbadian immigrant. From my conversation with him, Baskin School was somewhere over where... Baskin School, you not hearing me? Yeah, Baskin School is somewhere over where the Bratcher live at the hill up here. Yep, so that's where Baskin School was. After his mom moved to Fair Hall, he later attended the Brighton Government School, walking from Fair Hall to Brighton daily. Pops did not enjoy the daily journey to Brighton, and he would regularly get to school late or never showed up to class at all. As he got older during breaks from school, he frequented Jordan Morford Carpenter Shop in McCarty, and he later became an apprentice. He developed a love for carpentry, and he soon dropped out of school as the lure of a daily dollar was too enticing to ignore. A week's pay back then was only a few shillings. But for a young boy, it was a lot. From his early days at Jordan's Carpenter Shop, he grew to become a highly sought-after tradesman. By all accounts, he was a very skillful carpenter, working with some of the biggest names in the construction industry from the 1960s to 1991, when he finally retired from Mustique. Pops would have worked with companies such as Joachim Construction, Arnie Architect Services, and Amos Roberts Construction. Working on such buildings as the Baines Building, the old Juicy Building, Ford Bank, often called Penny Bank, and the Cotton House. Pops was always a smooth talker, and early in the 1960s, he struck up a relationship with my late mom. Over the course of the next 12 years, they had six kids together, two girls and four boys. A few years after the birth of his last child, Pops began his first stint as a carpenter on the island of Mustique. Living in crowded bunk houses and surviving the challenges of mosquito-infected island to support his family. After about 8 years, he left Mustique and migrated to Trinidad to be closer with his mom. He did not fancy Trinidad much, so he moved back to St. Vincent, and in 1983, he returned to Mustique for a second time, working for an additional 8 years before finally retiring in 1991. After he left Mustique, Pops turned to the land full time as a way to continue supporting his family. He rented some lands from Gwenny Gittins down to Saltwood and became heavily involved in commercial agriculture, focusing primarily on sweet potatoes and edibles. And as you heard my cousin said earlier, he was a provider for a lot of friends and family. Often reaping up to 20 sacks of potatoes in a single harvest. In addition to the land at Saltwood, Pops had some land down to McCarthy, gifted to him by his mom, where he would often plant a variety of root crops, mainly for home consumption and to be gifted to friends and loved ones. He was an excellent farmer, with a green thumb. Everything he touches invariably led to bountiful harvest. My earliest memory of my dad was him teaching me how to play dominoes when I was about 7. I enjoyed spending time with him while he and his friends would often play dominoes and pijo. He was a bit of a sore loser, but don't tell him I said that. But I will forever cherish those memories. Dad had a love for Christian music, with Jim Reeves and Joseph Nyes being his primary artist of choice, hence the reason for the tribute a little earlier. On Sundays, he would play Jim Reeves' cassette all day. And you know what happened to cassettes when they get hot. But by the next weekend, my dad would have replaced that cassette. And the process repeated itself quite a few times. Pops made a mean stewed chicken back and steamed provision. It was one of the only reasons, as a young boy, I looked forward to going down to Southwood to dig potatoes, the things I would do for good food. My dad was infuriating at times, but many will remember him for his brash bravado and his capricious sense of humor. He enjoyed telling stories and having healthy discussions with his friend. He was very witty and had a passion for talking nonsense. One of my fondest memories of his love for nonsense is during one of his many discussions with the deceased Vibert Crab Richards, Toby, Goody, Billy, and others, he asked, which hand they use to wipe their bottom when they use the toilet? And to a man, they would all reply, their right hand, to which my dad would say, oh, you're too nasty. I don't use my hand, I use toilet paper. Dad did not have many close friends, but when he accepted you into his world, you became his friend for life. The bond with which he developed with the late O'Neill banker Joseph was unbreakable. It was a good thing we grew up in a different time, because as friends, they would visit each other at home and often took slow walks together around Belmont. Leslyn Davis recently reminded me of seeing them walking together and thinking that's a true friendship. I don't know what takes place at the cemetery after burial, nor would I like to know. But if there's any type of spiritual awakening, my dad and banker will be over the moon to see each other again. After the passing of his dear friend, he became closer to Gutti and Toby, whom he called the old dog. And just like before with Banker, his bond with Toby was very strong until the end. One of the Ten Commandments teaches us to honor thy father and thy mother. And like our mom before, we all have come to love, respect, and respect dad. And we will forever cherish his memories. Cherishing his memories are his children, Robina and Zaldine residing in the USA, Sadie in Antigua, Fastina in Trinidad, Clergyman and Glaston in St. Kitts, Erica and Gershom in St. Vincent, Zelpha John, also known as Twist, and I feel predeceased him. Also cherishing his memories is his sister Louise Cupid in Camden Park and Agnes John residing in McCarty. 16 grandchildren, 11 great-grandchildren, and 2 great-great-grandchildren. Several nephews and nieces, including the Wilson family of Fairhall and Arnesvale, the John and Roberts family of McCarty, Natalie John and family of Lockwar, the Cupid family of Camden Park, the McCaws and John family of Belmont, including his first cousin, Alec Babash John. Many other friends and loved ones too numerous to mention. May God grant him everlasting rest, and may his light eternally shine on him. Thank you.
Amen.
Amen. Come. Can I
pray God blessing this morning as we hear the words from his son, that in all the things that he uses to do and see, this is just in memory. So we give God praise and thanks for the strength that he has given to him, that he could have accomplished all that he has done. But most importantly, through the hope that he has given his life, that this is what comes to the Lord Jesus Christ. Because all that was said here will be just in him. Amen? Praise the Lord. Now we have the hymn Forever with the Lord.
Thank you.
Now we have the Father's now. We will be taken from St. John chapter 14, verses 1 to 6, and then we have verse 27 by Deacon Ezekel.
Pleasant good morning, everyone. The gospel is from St. John chapter 13, chapter 14, sorry, St. John chapter 14 from verse 1 to 6 to 27 and 27. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And where I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not where thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. 27. Peace I leave unto you, with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. The Gospel of Christ.
Amen. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, the world without end. Amen. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Now we have the word by our canon, Knight of the Host, the Dean of the Cathedral. Let us welcome him as he comes to us.
Good afternoon, church. It's a blessing being here again to speak to you the word of God. I pray God that you're happy. Are you happy in the church this morning? Can you put your hands together and give the Lord a God offering of praise? Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. This is not a time of being sad. This is a time of worship, amen? Amen. Can we all stand? Hallelujah. I don't want you to help me sing as we worship God.
I love him, I love him, because he first loves me, and he watches my salvation on Calvary. Can you see that love him?
Hallelujah, praise God, on down.
But oh God, I depend upon you this hour, dear Lord. Oh God, the holy anointing, oh God, be upon me this time, Lord. Anoint my throne, oh God, deliver your word to your people, oh God. I want to comfort you, Lord. I want to focus upon you, oh God. Some of these sad in their hearts, Lord, be broken, Lord. But at the end of this message, oh God, let be joyful, oh God, and find favor with you, oh God. Father, I want to thank you, God. I praise and I glorify you, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen. We have to get in and worship the Lord. Be excited in the church. We are not here as a dead church, but we are living in the Lord, amen? And let us worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. The Bible tells us, in the book of Lamentations chapter 3, it's because of the mercy of God that we are not consumed, amen? That mercy is renewed every morning. So great is the faithfulness of God. Are you glad that you're alive today? I am glad in my life that I can continue to spread the good news of salvation to a lost world. We all live in the world that is lost, and therefore Christ has called us, those of you who are called, to go forth and to carry the message of salvation. We are here on behalf of the brother who has left this path and is gone somewhere else where I don't know. Praise the Lord. But it's, as a matter of fact, our prayer now, that is, we all want to be glad to be saved. I do not know. And I'm not here to present a glorious gospel to you. Oh, that God is speaking to the gates, into the poor gates of heaven. I don't know. But God knows, amen? Yes. His destination has been already settled. Amen, somebody? I say destination has already been settled. So no matter what you do here today, no matter what you do, no matter how sweet and dead you sing, that can make it better or worse for you. If you didn't like it, if you didn't love him, if you have bad mind against him, that he had no better or worse now. He's gone. Amen? He's no longer here with us, somebody. Amen? He's gone. What is here is only the outer cast, the outer carcass of man. The greater, Paul says, greater is he that is in me than he who that is in the world. God made us, hallelujah, for his purpose and for his glory. Can you tell your neighbor, God made you for his glory? Don't be ashamed. Tell your neighbor, God made every one of us. God made us for his glory and for his purpose. But the question is, at the end of life journey, can we say well done? Can we say well done? Some of us think, when peace like a river, I tell him my way, it is well with my soul. I can't tell you whether or not it is well with the soul of the brother. What is God? He's gone. Praise the Lord. As I was sick this morning, some of you did not know it. But let me apologize, the musician has some work to do, so therefore that person not here attending our grandmother was in the hospital. Praise the Lord. So praise the Lord. If you have, you can help me sing, you could jump, you clap your hands. You know, Baptist, we used to clap a long time ago, we have music now, so we don't really clap our hands much. Not only that, others clap your hands. Our hands are instruments of music, amen? Amen. And we can worship the Lord with the Bible says, clap your hands. All you people, make a joyful noise. So before we can sing, can we all stand again? I want you to do some exercise now. Can we all stand again? I don't want you to jump sleep with me. Praise the Lord. I want to see you stand, church. I'm excited. Praise the Lord. We all got a cross for thee. Oh, we all. God. Come to the blessing that you have life still today. But make use of the life that God gave you for a short time. The brother has lived his appointed and a good old age. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Somebody say live a full life. And when everybody listens to you, I really think, I wonder, the Bible says, you know, if you want to live long, be obedient to your parents.
Amen.
And I'm happy I really live that long life. And I pray that his soul, from my point, is right. But if it's been right before, it can't be right again, amen. There's no repentance, somebody said it really, amen. And therefore, I want to thank God for the life that he lived. We could thank God for someone's life, amen. I want to ask one question. We have a great class, I say great, but you can say I'm not great, Jesus. You know, can you praise somebody? Can you praise anybody, somebody?
Yes.
Yes, my amen. Yes. What does Solomon say? I'd rather praise the dead because they're harmless.
Amen.
So don't make nobody tell you no. I want to say this and don't be afraid to talk because you see, when we're evangelizing, I have no fear. You know, recently I talked to somebody and I would get fed up sometimes of the way that people speak. And they call themselves believers in God. But it's a shame sometimes how many of us speak to you. I go to the graveyard to speak to my mother. Shame for people who call themselves. Don't make nobody tell you. You can't go to the grave to speak to your brother. He's gone. The balance of the soul is finished. I remember thinking the book of 1 Samuel chapter 28. I'm going to tell you more about the scripture just now. I remember there was a woman, as a matter of fact, Saul the king, he put all of the wizards out of the land. All those who he would be trapped, he put them out. But Saul, after lose, you know, fail to worship God, God established to Paul, either by prophets, all of those other cases, God was listening to Saul. Yes, we all need advice. I will need somebody to talk to, amen? But trust in the Lord with all of your heart. So when you feel that nobody's wrong, you turn to God. But Saul turned to a woman and end up seeking for somebody who could divine up Prophet Samuel. That was God's sovereign, that was God's prophet. And let us not be deceived by the old deceiver, the devil, because he's out to deceive. And I believe that it is. So what Saul, he went, he get in connection with a woman and God. And you know what? I want Samuel, I want to hear from him, I want to know how to start this battle. What? Whatever the woman did, but she was worried because, oh, you already put these things on the land, why you go back to me now, you want to kill me? But she did. So I'm not going to interpret for you, I want you to read, and I want you to understand. Samuel, you know, the woman said, I see gods coming upon your poor woman friend. You know? And I think Saul said, was even by our Lord Samuel. Brothers and sisters, and I learned already from that lesson. Because, you know, one of the things I understand is I told you, Pastor, if you go to the graveyard, get out. You are going to control with demons, not anything of God. So let's be very careful. The Bible says that when you pass this life, your breath goes back, amen? It goes back. It comes from God, and God is going back. The thoughts perish. They know nothing. The brother said, he knows nothing about you, my friend. He's like this. If you are here, if you are here, so does know anything. And that's how the brother is. When we leave here to go to the burial ground, we're not going to place a spirit in the burial ground. Can I have anything from somebody? We're going to place that which comes from the earth, which is earthy, we're going to place that back to the earth. But his spirit is no longer there. That's why we call him dead. But the Bible says, if you're in Christ, hallelujah, you don't dare, but you live forevermore. You've gone to take a sleep in the arms of the Lord. I want to know that here, he will bring you back with him when he comes again. So brothers and sisters, I want you to understand very clearly. We are here this morning to bring a word of comfort. Some of you might be grieving, you might be sorrowful, that your brother has gone, or your uncle, or your daddy, he has gone. Even in the book of St. John chapter 14, Jesus Christ bring a word of comfort. He tried to comfort the hearts of his disciples that troubled. Don't be intimidated. Because he was encouraging them and setting them up, because I'll eventually be taken out of this world. So therefore I have to go back to my Father. But when Jesus went back, he did not just go. He sent a paraclete, sent somebody. He sent a comforter to comfort in us today. So he come back in the form of the Holy Ghost to comfort us. And therefore, he encouraged disciples, don't be troubled. Be strong. Be encouraged. I'm going to prepare for you. I'm going to a beautiful place to prepare. And I will come back to receive you unto myself. And where I am, there you will be also. Let us prepare our hearts, my friends, to be with the Lord when he comes again. But we could only be with him. Religion can't carry your mind. Your pastor can't carry your mind. Your prophet or elder will not be able to get you there. They will encourage you to get there, but the blood. Hallelujah. Can somebody see the blood? The blood of Jesus Christ and the salvation of your soul that will get you into the kingdom of God. Because many of us as pastors will preach something, you know, but we are lost. There are many pastors who preach the gospel, but they are lost. So therefore, just trust God that he will give you, he will anoint you, he will bless you, and he will redeem your life. As I said to someone this morning, you don't got to be baptized to be saved. Repent and so trust the Lord. Confess the Lord Jesus Christ as a Savior, and he will save your soul. My brothers and sisters, the greatest miracle that can take place in your heart is when you give your life to the Lord. And we want to give you an opportunity here this morning to turn your heart to the Lord. If you have not, it's important. As I said before, you are created for the glory of God. God created you and he loves you. Because God loves us. He loves us so much. And he says, my will that none should perish, but all, hallelujah, all should come to repentance. That is important, my beloved friend. So friend, maybe you're troubled. We are here to comfort you. We are here to give you a word of hope. As Paul declares, have hope in the Lord. You know, I'm going to jump and come back. Paul declares in 1 Thessalonians chapter, I love very much. You know, I don't want to be ignorant concerning those who are asleep. Now, can I say, I'm not anybody who loves to be ignorant? If you love to be ignorant, just from here. None of us, all of us want to be open. All of us want to have knowledge in it. And that is what Paul was doing in 1 Thessalonians chapter 13, 14 here. That was what Paul was doing. He said, I don't want to have you to be ignorant concerning those who sleep. There's life, my friend, beyond the grave. Hallelujah. I say there's life again beyond the grave. So that's the final destination. If we are saved and we are the Lord, our final destination, it will be the paradise of God. But if you are not saved, hallelujah, you will appear to God before the great white throne in judgment, where you will be judged. The Bible says, if you all those, they will be cast into the lake of fire that burn. The Bible declares, not even the worm died not. Can you imagine a life where you are living all eternal ages? I know, yes, some people think, oh, there is no hell. Beloved friend, that's what the Lord says. I believe in the days of Noah, praise the Lord, there are many people who will say the same thing. Nothing is going to happen. Maybe they mocked Noah when he was building the master boat. Until the sea of waters, oh Lord, maybe they cry, Father, Noah, open for us. But somebody declares, too late, shall be the cry. And you want to hear those words? My beloved friends, you have an opportunity in our life that you can make it right with the Lord. Amen. That you can make it right now with your life. You have life, and this, you can make it right with the Lord. If you haven't, we're going to give you an opportunity to make it right with the Lord. Praise be to the name of Jesus. The final verse. I'm not going to go to all. Praise in John 14. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Oh, yes, 70. Praise the Lord. You know, the Bible says to comfort one another in these words. And therefore, friends, we are here to comfort you with the word of Almighty God. Now with my words, because my words will be just vain. You may not like to hear what I said. But God says, Jesus says, to comfort. In verse 27, peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. Believe in God.
Believe also in me. If you're troubled-hearted today, Jesus Christ is our comforter, and he can rescue you. He can set you free from that burden that you're carrying now. Maybe you're sorry, praise the Lord. You're feeling sad because your brother, your uncle, daddy has gone. But as I said, when Mary, praise the Lord, when Lazarus died, hallelujah. Oh Lord God, someone declares he's going to come again. But then Jesus declared, oh Lord, Lazarus is not dead. Hallelujah. If the brother is in the casket or the coffin, if he believes in God, he's not dead. But he's going to God for sleep. Can somebody say amen? Can somebody show praise God? As I said, if he knew the Lord as Savior, he is not dead. These are not my words, these are the words of Christ. He only gone to a resting place until the Lord ready for him. Finally, in the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, praise the Lord. And I love the words of Paul. As I said to you before, he said, I don't want you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those who sleep. Those who sleep, the believers. Those who sleep. But I want you to know what it's like after that. Have hope in the Lord. And we exhort you, we encourage you to have hope in the Lord. Jesus said, you know, yes, in the resurrection, as he said, no, yes, we're going to see him on the resurrection day again. But Jesus Christ, beyond that, he's not dead, he's alive. And I'm going to wake him up for you to see. Praise the Lord. God can do it. So, brothers and sisters, I encourage your heart. Have hope in the Lord. Don't be downhearted. That's what we're here for, to encourage your heart. Don't be downhearted. You're in a place where you can be satisfied, where your soul can be rescued from the dead, from hell. Praise the Lord. And we thank God again for his blessing. Praise the Lord. I will read some of the words and then at least, you know, I will try to close this. Praise God. The dead in Christ shall rise first. Amen. The dead in Christ shall rise first. So if the brother here is in Christ, he will be one of the first ones to be raised from the dead. Amen. Now, I want to say this to you. Where is the first? Is there a second? Is there a second? In other words, he said this will be first resurrection. That means to say, after the first resurrection, there will be those still in the grave. Amen? And they who are risen first will not hinder those of us. Or those of us who are alive will not hinder those. So therefore, when the dead in Christ, remember the dead in Christ, they shall rise first. They shall be part of the first resurrection. And therefore, there will be a second resurrection. I want you to understand that. So therefore, our encouragement, live the life so you can be part of that first resurrection. The trumpet of God shall sound. The trump. Did the Bible say trump or trumpet? Trump. I'm talking about trump in America now. As somebody says his name is in the Bible, so, you know, he's in prophecy. The trump of God shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Hallelujah. Those of us who remain alive, we shall be caught. As I was praying maybe something, this morning something, and we did a community lay group prayer, which we're doing for 40 days. We only got a few days now. And then what is, you know, I said, you know, that means, you know, let's be ready. Let's go get ready for the rapture. The rapture is there coming. Jesus Christ will also come soon. But something we act as if no judgment. But Christ is coming again, friends. He's coming again, and we have to prepare our hearts to meet him when he comes. So, we all want to be with the Lord. We all want to be in the judgment seat of Christ. We all want to be in a great marriage supper, praise the Lord. And therefore, I invite you, I encourage you to do so before time changes to eternity. So friends, I want to thank God for his blessing and for his help on us. I don't think I think it's time for me, but I want to thank God for his blessing. Thank everyone for coming. But I'm going to ask you at that moment now. According to what I've seen here, we're going to have no prayer for the family, because at this time, you know, you need a touch of God. So therefore, what we're going to ask you to do, I'm going to ask you to do some contemplation now. As I'm going to ask you to stand, if you can gather around the casket, it's a final moment, because even you will not be here. As a matter of fact, you're just going to have your last opportunity to, you know, to remember. Just make some contemplation. You can stand. Hallelujah. I'm not going to pray, because I have a seat here, but I'm not going to pray. I'm going to ask somebody from the audience. So get yourself ready. Maybe the daughter, maybe somebody. I'm going to ask, can those stand, bishops? Can those stand? It's a very important hour that we are going to know.
Can you gather on the casket if you don't want to talk? I love you to sit in. Praise the Lord. That's a part that we've done in our church. We ask the members of the family, it's a moment of condemnation to gather on the casket as we pray. And as we pray, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. According to the direction of security. Yes? Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. I'm going to ask Pastor Wilson to the prayer first. That's what God wants to happen. Praise the Lord. See what you're
there. Praise the Lord. So if you're there, come on, we're waiting on you for prayers. Praise the Lord. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Thank God.
Father God, as we bid farewell to his body, we are thankful that you have given us the opportunity to live on, the opportunity to live a little longer. And indeed, one day we too shall pass from life to death. But as the preacher said earlier, if we know the Lord, it will just be a transition. And God, help us to trust you. Help us to know you. Help us to have a personal relationship with you. And so at this time, we ask that you strengthen each one who may be feeling the loss or the emptiness of this loss. Strengthen each one, we pray. For the congregation, friends, and loved ones, strengthen us too, Father. For indeed, a part of us, our friend, our loved one, he is God. But God, thank you for grace. You give grace, even in times when there seem to be challenges and difficulties. We can depend upon your grace. We can draw from your grace. And so this afternoon, we are thankful because we are drawing from that grace today, the God of all grace and mercy. Blessed we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let's go back, yes. All the families of you are here. But one of the things that I want to ask, if you're not sure that God can receive you, you're going to ask, Lord, you have an opportunity to come to the life of the Lord. One reason is, remember, you're going to walk the same road. And therefore, the Lord will want you to go back without being saved. That's what Christ said on the cross, to give you an opportunity that you can trust Him. And if you want to forgive you of your sins, you say, anyone here on this cast will not see Him, and I'm willing to be the heart of the Lord, can you just wait another little bit? And again, I'm going to ask Pastor Moses to pray for you. I don't know where the Lord has given what they had to ask the resource. Anybody has not seen? Praise the Lord. Everybody has seen? Praise the Lord. Well, that's good. So if you are seen, you can go back to your seats. And if you feel convicted in your heart, you can talk to us later on or anytime. But God bless you as they talk back not to us. But as we exit, please remember where you are and allow the clergy to what for.
Praise the Lord. As we come to the close, we will sing I Fly.
I'm looking for the
Thank you. When I die, Thank you. It's probably another 10 or 15 minutes or so, but we're just keeping this thing rolling.
Thank you.
taken away.
Thank you.
Almighty God, with whom do we live? The spirit of those departed in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful, after they are delivered from the burden of flesh, have the joy and facility to give thee hearty thanks for the good example of all those thy servants who have finished their course in the faith to no rest from their labors. And we beseech thee that we with all those who are departed in the life, in the true faith of thy holy name, we have our powerful commission and bliss, both in the body and soul, and in thy eternal and everlasting glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For as much as it pleased Almighty God in his wise providence to take out of this world our deceased brother, we therefore commit his body to the ground or to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection in the last day and the life of the world to come, through our Lord Jesus Christ, whose second coming in glorious majesty to judge the world and the earth, and the sea shall give up the dead, and the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made like unto his own glorious body, according to the mighty working whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. Musician.
Thank you. Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and life. In whom we believe it, we shall live. We die, and whosoever liveth and believeth in him shall not die eternally. Who also hath taught us by the holy apostle Saint Paul not to be sorry as men without hope. For those who sleep in him, we humbly beseech thee, O Father, to raise us from the death of sin unto life of righteousness, that when we shall depart this life, we rest in him, and that at the general resurrection in the last day, we will be acceptable in thy sight, and receive that blessing which thy well-beloved Son shall then pronounce to all who love and fear thee, saying, Come ye blessed children of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of the world. Grant this, we beseech thee, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, our mediator and redeemer. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all, even forevermore. I will sing the song when the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and Christ shall be no more. The trumpet of the Lord shall sound.